Good morning, dear students. In our previous video, we have completed the half story of the lesson Fire in the Forest. Now we have seen that the forest had caught fire and the deer was trying to save her newly born baby. The fire was spread everywhere. And so the deer started to bite the fawn, and the fawn was scared of his mother. He did not understand why his mother was behaving in that way. But then meanwhile the fawn also started to feel the heat, so the fawn was very much scared. Now let's see what happens next. Just then the hind saw smoke ahead of her. It was still behind them. Just then, when she was trying to save her baby, she was trying to make the fawn move ahead. At that time she saw smoke in front of her as well as it was behind them. So now both of them, the deer, that is the hind, and the fawn, were caught in the fire from both the sides. Now they were trapped in the fire. Then she knew they were caught just the way you could be caught between two hunting panthers. Now both of them were caught in the fire just as you could be caught between the two panthers. So when the panthers attack from both the sides, it is very difficult for the deer to escape. It was a similar situation. Here the deer and her baby were caught in the fire from both the sides. Her fawn lay panting on the earth, stretched out. Sparks were falling all around. His flesh shivered when they fell on him, but he did not get up. Now her fawn lay panting. Panting means breathing heavily. The fawn was breathing very heavily. The sparks of the fire were falling all around. Some of the sparks fell on the fawn's body also. So whenever the sparks fell on the fawn's body, he shivered, means trembled. But he did not move from his place. As you know, I was newly born baby. He did not have that much energy to walk or to run. She could see the blaze now, roaring up in a sheet of fire and exploding bamboo. Now she could see the blaze. Blaze means strong flame. Blaze. Strong flame. Now the deer, the hind, could see the strong flame coming towards them and exploding bamboo. Exploding means bursting. So she could see the bursting bamboos as well. With smoking in eyes and nostrils, they panicked on. To and fro in short blind rushes, all sense knocked out of them by terror. Now, as they were caught in the fire from both the sides, so there was smoke all over, and because of smoke, their eyes started aching, and also there was an itching in their nose. So because of this, they got panic and they started to run to and fro here and there. They started to run here and there in short blind rushes, means without looking, as their eyes were itching. So without looking, they started to run here and there. Their all senses were knocked down. They could not feel anything. All the senses were knocked down because of terror. They were so much scared that they did not understand what to do. They were just afraid because their life was at risk. And so their senses did not work. They did not understand what to do. Suddenly, there opened before them a dried river bed cut deep in its course, and down there among the boulders was a big pool. So suddenly there was a dried river in front of them, and down among the rocks there was a big pool. So suddenly the deer and the fawn saw a riverbed, dried riverbed, and down among the boulders, that is rocks, there was a big pool. She knew this place well. A blundering show from his frantic mother sent him bowling over and over down the bank to end up bruised at the bottom. All the breath knocked out of his body, but right by the pool. Now that place was very well known to his mother. The deer knew that place very well, and so what she tried to do? She tried to save her child from the wildfire. The mother gave him uncalculated pushes so that she could push him into the pool. From his frantic mother, she kept on pushing the fawn until it reached to the bottom. Bowling over and over down the bank to end up bruised at the bottom. So as she kept on pushing the fawn, like means as you throw the ball and it rolls down, similarly deer pushed the fawn and it kept on bowling till it went to the bank and it was bruised. Means to have a bruise. Now what is bruise? Bruise means a bleeding skin. So as the mother pushed him on the ground, so he had some scratches on his body, and because of it was bleeding. To save a life of a child, mother could do anything. So here you can see she knew that it was hurting the child, but she was determined to save his life, and so she kept on pushing him into the pool. The strong heat of two fires began to beat down upon them from each side of the river bed to bake them to death. strong heat of the two fires. That is, which two fires? The wildfire or the forest fire which was caught, and the counter fire which the forest department had lit. So both of them were baking in the heat of this fire. The pool reflected the raging flames. The pool reflected the raging flames, raging furious. So the pool reflected these furious flames. The water fizzled with sparks. So the water fizzled with sparks. Fizzled means make sound. As the sparks of the flame fell into the water, it made sound. The hind shoveled her fawn forward to the edge of the water. So now the hind shoveled means applied a great force to push the fawn to the edge of the water. He lay there motionless but breathing more evenly. Now the fawn lay motionless. There was no motion, there was no movement in his body. But now he was breathing evenly. Earlier he was panting, he was breathing heavily. But now he was breathing evenly, normally. About them the fires raged. A whole tree heeled over, blazing, and fell into a long savage hiss and a boiling cloud of steam into the head of the pool. Still the fire did not extinguish. Still the fire was burning and it was very furious. A whole tree heeled over. Heeled over means tilted to the one side. So a tree was tilted to one side, blazing, and fell with a long savage hiss. So this tree, due to the fire, it was tilted on the one side and it fell down. It means it fell down very violently, and a boiling cloud of steam into the head of the pool. And as it was a burning tree, and when it fell into the water, it fell with a violent hiss and a boiling cloud. So it appeared as if it was a boiling cloud as the tree was burning. So it fell into the water. It sent the water washing out. As the tree fell into the water, it sent the water washing out. So the tree was washed out in the river water. The fawn struggled his head up, panting, gasping in the furnace, his eyes closing again and tongue lolling. Now the fawn, he struggled a lot, his head up, panting, gasping. Now as he was in the river, so he had to keep his head out of the water so that he could breathe easily. So he struggled to keep his head out from the water, and he was panting, he was breathing heavily, gasping. Gasping means to breathe with open mouth. When you keep your mouth open and breathe, that is called as gasping. So whenever you are very much tired, say after running race, you are very much tired and then you gasp. So similarly, as the fawn was very much tired, he struggled to keep his head out of the water and he lay panting and gasping. His eyes closing. So the fawn kept on closing his eyes and his tongue was lolling. Lolling means was outside. Have you seen the tongue of a dog? It's outside, always keeps the tongue out. So similarly here, the porn star was rolling out of his mouth. But at last, very slowly, the height of the flames became less. They sank down into piles of glowing ash. Now slowly, slowly, what happened? After a long time, the flames started to decrease. The size of the flame became less. Flames sank down into the glowing ash. So all the trees turned into ash. A cool breeze blew along the water course. All the air was full of choking smoke. Now they could feel the cool air along the water course, and everywhere in air there was smoke all around. The fawn was not strong enough to move yet, so he and his mother stayed there while their burns cooled in the pool, drinking the tepid water in which one or two dead fish floated upside down. Now yet the fawn was not strong enough to walk. So deer and the fawn, they stayed there for some more time in the pool. So while staying there, their burns cooled in the pool. As they were sitting in the pool, so their burns cooled down. Drinking the tepid water in which one or two dead fish floated upside down. They drank the tepid water. Tepid means slightly warm. Because of the fire, the water of that pool became slightly warm. So they drank that water in which one or two dead fish were floating. The fish in the pond also died due to the heat of the fire. When he had recovered and was strong enough, they moved into the unburnt forest and presently joined the herd again. So when the fawn was totally well, when he recovered, when he got the energy, at that time deer and the fawn, both of them moved to the another forest which was unburnt, and then they again joined their herd. So in this way you can see how mother saved the life of a child. So how did the deer save the fawn? So the hind, or the deer, saved her baby by pushing and nudging it towards the river bed and among the rocks there was a pool. So both of them stayed there until the fire died off. So from this lesson, what do you understand about mother's instinct to save its child? To save the fawn from the fire, the hind nips him, nudges him. She also pushes him. She knows that she is hurting him, but she wants to save him from the fire, and so she keeps on pushing him forward as she wants to save her child at any cost. As the fawn was newly born, it did not have energy to move ahead, so the hind kept him pushing forward. So this shows that mother can do anything to save her child. So in this way, hind was successful in saving her child. I hope you have understood the lesson. Thank you.